Hallelujah. Shalom, Yisrael. Dubarak. All you that are listening by via of live stream that have joined us on this beautiful Shabbat, that we could gather together to hear the wonderful words of Almighty Yahweh, correction, absolutely, reproof, instruction. He gives us those words, Yisrael, and that is his dabar, that we may grow. That we may grow tzaddik, righteously, in his truth and in his word. A plant will not grow right, no matter where it is. It could be a weed. If the right necessities for that plant, that flower, whatever it may be, that tree, if it's not there, it's not going to grow. So Yahweh, he puts into us, and he fertilizes us daily as we are in his bayah, as we are working by his mishpah, because he knows the things that we have need of. He knows that this needs to be pruned. There's a little too much of that element, so he gives us his mishpah and his Torah to eradicate certain things, eradicate certain diseases, eradicate those things that we allow in ourselves that are not of him. So he says, I give this one a little bit of that, just enough. Well, this one needs more of that. That plant needs more of this. Why? Because you can see by the persona of what one shows, even on the outward man, those things which are lacking, those things that are needed, they're visual. And one that has wisdom, that has hukmar, that have experience in life, that have experienced certain situations, certain things many a time, they can look upon the face of one and they're able to discern. They know you need to drink water. You need to eat more of this, more of that. You need to stop this. You need to do more of that. But what I want to bring to us today in the simplicity of Torah truth is this word that I have been studying, going over and over again, and I have not found all of the truth of it, which... But the little that I do have today, Yisrael, I want to share this with us concerning without. Without. And most importantly for us to understand, it's more than just one lacking. It's more than someone standing outside, if someone was outside the door. There are certain implications and examples of this word that we may understand. I want to go through that today, Yisrael. First of all, it says here in Bereshit in Genesis chapter 6, verse 11, as Yahweh, he speaks unto us a house concerning our corruption, concerning our lack, because we are a people that are without many things. And we believe that we possess, that we have it all. Our looks, we think we're the most handsome or the most attractive. And we don't realize what we lack and what we are without. You're not what you think you are. I'm not what I think I am. But yet Yahweh, he takes his time, as he has done this morning, to show us by Torah what we must do. He says here in Bereshit, Genesis chapter 6, verse 11, concerning the Olam Yisrael, he says, the earth also was corrupt before Almighty Yahweh. The corruption of the earth. You know, when the Torah speaks about earth, it's more than just the ground that we walk upon. He's talking about people, men, the inhabitants of the Olam, the Ritz. Yes. It all belongs unto Almighty Yahweh. We all belong unto Almighty Yahweh. The breath goes back unto him. Why? Because he gives Ruach to every man. So he speaks of the Olam. He said it is corrupt. Men are corrupt. The women are corrupt. The children, the Zakane. He says, the earth before Almighty Yahweh was corrupt. And also it was filled with violence. That's how you know one is corrupt. When you're corrupt, when you find yourself, you're full of violence. When you're against your Akim, you're a whole king. Where it seems any little thing calls you to detour off of the path of Siddiq, and it should not. You're full of violence. Well, my voice, I didn't raise my voice, and I spoke quietly, and it doesn't mean nothing. You're full of violence because you reject the mitzvah, the Torah, what he speaks. Verse 12. And Yahweh, he looked upon Adam, the Olam, the earth, and behold, he examined it. Not only did he see the world visually, he know what lies within the heart of each and every man. He said, and behold, it was corrupt. It was sahah. It was corrupt. Rotten. There was a stench there. There was a lacking there. There was a people without substance. Without those things that are needed, Israel. And if your body don't have the substance, those things that are needed, if you are out certain elements, then you will find yourself smelling your breath.
I know that, man.
In your efforts to work and labor, you'll find yourself weak in strength. Why? Because we lack. We're without. Certain things we are without. So Yahweh, he looks upon us today, Israel. He sees where we are lacking. We're without. Verse 13. He said that in verse 13. And Yahweh said unto Noah, the end of all flesh, it has come up before me. It was Yahweh's judgment. He said the end of flesh, the raging of flesh, the expression of flesh, it had come up before me. For the earth is filled with violence, he says, through them. Through those that are corrupt. Through those that reject the mitzvah, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. And behold, he said, I will destroy them with the Olam. He said, the earth is corrupt. Those that have corrupted it, because the people have not walked according to the Torah. We have not walked according to the Torah. He said, I will destroy them along with the Olam. And in verse 14, he commanded Noah to make you an ark of gopher wood. He said, rooms you shall make in the ark, and you shall pitch it. Well, what does this have to do with being without? Yeah. I will get to that, Yisrael, because this is very important. Yeah. That Yahweh, when he does a thing, he is always perfect and it's complete. What he put within one, it also is revealed on the outside. As we hear even the mitzvah of the Torah, what's in the lamp of the heart of one, is it not expressed? Do you not see it in one's facial expression? Do you not see it in one's ability to coordinate or to do certain things? You know what's in the heart of one if they don't want to do something. A child, when it's instructed, you know when that child really don't want to do it. They don't really, boy, hurry up and do that. You see it by the expression. So you know that inwardly, he doesn't want to do that. Why? Because it was expressed outwardly. So Yahweh, he wants his Torah to be expressed within our most inner parts. Inside. That we're not without, that we do not lack. But the Torah, as it is put into us, that it is expressed in our outward man. And what we do, and what we express. So if we understand what he expresses even unto Noah, and as I read on, even the ark, even the ark of the covenant, it was laid both inside and outside with gold, but not just any kind of gold, pure gold. So as I get into this teaching, Israel, I do want to start out with the expression of within, that we may understand the things that we are without. Even that we may understand why we are even outside of the mitzvah, the Torah, the covenant of Almighty Yahweh. So he goes on in verse 14. He says, make an ark of gopher wood, rooms you shall make in the ark, and you shall pitch. In other words, you shall cover, or you shall kofar it within and without with this coating or this pitch. Why? It was necessary to waterproof, to seal, When we are building a building, you have to have caulking, silicone, paint, certain things that the building is sealed, that it can resist water, that it can resist the elements. So Yahweh instructed Noah exactly what to cover or to coat. They have not the dom of Yahshua HaMashiach? Does it not cover us, Yisrael? So if we are covered in the dom of Yahshua HaMashiach, both inwardly, it is revealed outside. Is it not? The way we dress, we don't dress like we used to dress in the world. We don't commune with our whole king like we did in the world with foolishness and frivolity and with this false persona. Why? Because Yahweh has filled us. He has covered us. Hallelujah. Is not Yahshua HaMashiach? Is he not our Peshach? So we are covered. We are covered by the Torah. We are covered by the mitzvot of Almighty Yahweh. And then that which is within us, will it not be seen? Will it not be noticed, Yisrael? Will it not be people and nations, people that walk by and they see you and they wonder? They glance and they gaze at you, Yisrael. Why? Because those things that are within us, Yisrael, those things are within the heart, within the left, within the mind, they are going to be expressed outside. They will be revealed, Yisrael. So I desire that Yahweh will show me, show us, Yisrael, those things that we are without today. Hallelujah. With this simple teaching of Torah, this mitzvot of Almighty Yahweh. Because Yahweh, he judges us when we allow wickedness to enter in. Listen to what it says here in Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 15. Hallelujah. It talks about Yeshurun. He said, Yeshurun, you have waxed fat. He is judging Yeshurun. Not only does he see the physical appearance, but he also talks about the lev, the heart, the mind has grown fat. You have grown fat to the point that you kicked. Yes, he said, and kicked. He said, you are waxing fat. Yes. You have grown thick. Yes. Have we allowed ourselves to grow thick, Yisrael? Yes. We have this thick outer shell that we don't allow the Torah to penetrate. Yes. I recall in my youth, the Zakane'im or the elders or whoever spoke or preached, we used the term the battle axe. And the battle axe was a heavy piece of equipment, a tool with a sharp edge. And it's very heavy, almost what we would use to split the wood, a maul. But there would be nothing that could withstand the blow of a battle axe. He said, you have grown thick, and you are covered with fatness. He said, you're covered with fatness. Why? Because you have allowed things into your life that you have grown fat and resisting the Torah, that it cannot penetrate your life in your heart and your mind. Why? Why is he covered with this fatness? It says here, then he forsook Yahweh, which had made him. Have not Yahweh made us all? The Torah says he has made everyone, everything which we see, which we encounter, Yahweh has made all things. He said, you have grown fat because of that. You have forsook Almighty Yahweh, which had made you. And has lightly esteemed, the Torah says, the rock, the foundation, that cornerstone that is laid, that place where Yahweh has put us, Yisrael, that we will stand in the midst of adversity, in the midst of trial or tribulation, when we are tried hard by the elements of the enemy, and even by the mitzvah, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh that proves us, that tries us. He said, you have forsaken, you have lightly esteemed the rock of your Yasha, your salvation. We have forgotten Yah. We have trodden over the dom of Yahshua HaMashiach. Why? Because we have allowed ourselves to become fat with the cares of this life, with the desires of flesh. We have not exercised emunah as we should. We have not burnt off the excess wickedness, these calories that cause us to grow fat. We have not done those things. We have not allowed the fire of Almighty Yahweh to burn off those unclean things. Just right, y'all. Verse 16, as he moves on. Talk about Yeshurun now, this Ruach, this spirit. He said, they provoke Almighty Yahweh, they provoke him unto jealousy with many strange abominations. Does it say many? It didn't say with few, did it? It didn't say one. He said with many. With many. Can a number really be placed on many? He says with many. He said, you have provoked Almighty Yahweh with jealousy, with many strange abominations, provoking him to off, to anger. And what do we do? What did they say to Yeshurun did? He says, they sacrifice unto devils and not unto Almighty Yahweh. You see what the fatness of this spirit that Yeshurun, this is talking about us today, Israel. It's talking about me. We have allowed ourselves to come fat. That we have walked away from the mishpah, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. And we sacrifice unto devils, unto everything. We give exaltation unto everything. We break our bodies down to serve flesh. You bow your knee at the wicked. That they may have something, quote, good, unquote, to say about you and for you. It is wrong, Israel. We seek to serve them more than we seek to serve Almighty Yahweh. He said, you have done this sacrifices and not unto Almighty Yahweh. He says, to gods whom you do not even know. He said, to gods, they have no value. They have no strength. They cannot hear. They cannot speak any kind of truth. It would be better off if you find a Zakane or a righteous man than to worship and serve these gods. If you even find a strong man, at least there is some substance. At least there is something to be admired, but you go to gods, which cannot help you, cannot instruct you. He said, which you do not even, yada, you do not even know. You don't even know who you are serving. You don't even know who you're bringing your sacrifices to. He says, and new gods that came up, whom your fathers, they fear not. He said, you're serving things that even your fathers have not even heard of. Certainly there's nothing new under the sun, but he said, even the fathers have not even heard these things that we're doing. Even the fathers, our fathers, did not even do, Yisrael. Verse 18. He said, of the rock that begot you, have established you, have birthed you, have placed you in your position. Yahweh has placed us where we are today, Yisrael. But he says, you have forgot even the rock that has begotten you. He said, you are unmindful. Did Dawid say that his mind would be upon the Torah, the mitzvot of Almighty Yahweh, day and night? He said, we're unmindful and have forgotten Yahweh that has formed you. Verse 19. And when Yahweh saw it, he said that Yahweh, he abhorred it. What is that? He abhorred it. He condemned it. He despised it. It had no pleasure in it, Yisrael. Yeah. He said he abhorred them because of the provoking of his sons and of his daughters. Have we provoked Almighty Yahweh? I have provoked Yah. We have provoked Yah, Yisrael. That's why he continually shows those things that we are without, Yisrael. Without Emunah, without his mitzvot, his mitzvah. Without the Zakane, once he take the Zakane, the word, the mitzvah out of Yisrael, we search and study Torah, we find always that Yisrael failed. Verse 20. And he said, I will hide my face from them, and I will see what their end shall be, for they are a very forward generation. Yes. Children. Yes. He says, children in whom there is no faithfulness. He says there's no emunah. They're without emunah. There's no firmness. There's no fidelity. True ahava. He said, there's no steadfastness. That's what the rock and the cornerstone is for. Why? Because we have forsaken Yahshua HaMashiach, the cornerstone. Verse 21. He said, because they have moved me to jealousy with that which is not Kodesh, they have provoked me to anger with their vanity. See, we have provoked him. We have provoked Yahweh to anger with our vanities, things that have no substance. We worship things that have no substance, Yisrael. He said, I will remove them to jealousy with those which are not a people. He said, by my jealousy and my anger, he said, I will remove those which are not a people. And I will provoke them to anger with a foolish nation. He said he will provoke those. Why? Because we have been a foolish nation, Israel. We have not walked according to the statutes of Almighty Yahweh. Verse 22. For as fire is kindled in my anger, and shall not burn to the lower Sheol, and shall consume the earth with her increase, and set on fire even the foundations of the mountains. He said, I will heap mischief upon them, and I will spin. He said, I will shoot my arrows upon them. We think Yahweh's not shooting our arrows, or he's not shooting his arrows, Israel. He's hitting the mark on target. He knows who we are and our frailties. He knows our transgression and our iniquity, Yisrael. So when he speaks unto me, when he speaks unto us, Yisrael, he doesn't shoot an arrow not intend to hit his target. When he spins his arrow, he hit his target every time, Yisrael. Why? Because he shows us what we are without. Without a hava. Showing the lack, Yisrael. He also said in verse 23, he said, I will heap mischief upon them, and I will spend my arrows upon them. Verse 24. He said, they shall be burned with hunger and devoured with burning heat and with bitter destruction. You know, it's something when destruction comes.
Yes.
There are those that, because it is so intense, they don't know what hit them. It takes their life like that. But it's another thing in the destruction where you feel the anguish and the hurt and the pain with bitterness. That you're able to look around and see those things that are torn down and what you're without.
Yes, understand.
That's what Yahweh says he would do unto us. He said he will allow us in this burning heat and with bitter destruction. And will also send the teeth of beasts upon them. With the poison of the serpents of the dust. As Yahweh showing his anger, his jealousy, Israel. Why? Because we come to everything and everyone but unto him. Hallelujah. Let us come unto Almighty Yahweh for everything, Israel. For our needs. For all men, I need Almighty Yahweh. I need Yahshua HaMashiach. I need his ahava, his forgiveness, Israel. And he says here in verse 21. He said, they have moved me to jealousy. Hallelujah. They have moved me to jealousy. They have provoked me to anger with their vanities. He said, I will remove them. I will cast them away with those things that are not a people and will reprove them to anger with the foolish nation. Moving down. Verse 25. He says this, even after all this, he wants us to understand this destruction, his wrath, his anger. He says in verse 25 of Deuteronomy 32, he says, the sword without. He said, the sword is without. Do we not see, as we read the destruction that Yahweh does upon this nation, this people, this Yeshurun?
Yes.
Do we not think we will look at our lives? And Yisrael as a whole, the destruction that has been caused because of our iniquities, because of our sin. We have forgotten Almighty Yahweh to the point that we are without any kind of mitzvah, with Torah, without any kind of emunah to stand. He said the sword is without destruction, the anguish. It is evident And he said, there's also terror that is within. Is there terror?
Yes.
Do we fear Israel, y'all? He said, the sword is without. We see the sword. We see the pestilence. We see the lack, and we see the need. And yet Yahweh, he will restore all those things that have been taken, even by the pommel worm, all the destruction. If we would just obey what he commands us in Torah, obey his mitzvot, Yisrael. He said, the sword without and terror within. He said, that shall destroy. Sokol, that is to take away. That is to make a nation or a people childless. There's nothing more destructive than making a nation or a people childless. More than just wiping them out, you're making them childless, where they cannot produce, where they cannot bear forth seed. Yahweh said he would do this to a people and to a nation that have grown fat within and that has forgotten the rock of their salvation, of their Yashak. He said, I will destroy. He said, I will make you childless. I will make you barren, both young man and the virgin. He said, the suckling also, and with the man of gray hairs. He said, I will cause that. He said, the sword, my judgment, is not his word as a two-edged sword, Yisrael. And we should see the evidence of that amongst the cold, the nation of Yisrael. Even his word, if we will look at the world in its present state, we see that Yahweh, his word, is point on point. His arrow land in every point and place that he desires it. And we'll be a people that are wise, and if we will observe, as we are taught so many times, we will see how the Torah of Almighty Yahweh fits in every situation and in every circumstance. Why? Because Yahweh here is not mocked. What we sow as a people, we're going to reap it, Israel. When we do what we think in the inward parts and within, it will be shown without, because Yahweh should judge us with his sword, Israel. So anything within we're hiding within us, within one, you're not hiding from Almighty Yahweh. Why? Because the sword is without. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He goes on as I continue into helium. Because as I said at the beginning of this message, I want to deal with these things that are within. And Dawi gives us a platform in which we can observe these things, Israel. Yeah. What lies within the lev of man. Tehillim 51, starting at verse 6. The things that Yahweh desires, the things that we should have as a people, as a nation. Those things that should be within one. Sometimes you have to look at what's in the vessel to understand what the vessel is lacking. You need to add some of this. You just need to be added to the ingredients. That it may be brought up to the right level. That it may be full, Yisrael. He says, behold, you desire truth in the inward parts. Yahweh, he desires truth with the inward parts, Yisrael. That we stand, that we fight, that we die out, even to our own lusts, Yisrael, and our own ways, that we may have truth, that we may have tzaddik, righteousness, because that's what he desires in the inward parts. And in the hidden part, that which is not seen, he said, you shall make me to know hukmah. You should make me to know wisdom.
Yes.
I want to be made to know wisdom, Yisrael. But we must have tzaddik. We must have righteousness where? Inwardly. In the inward parts. And what does that entail? What does that do? Well, the cleansing, it starts from within, does it not, Yisrael? We have to cleanse our minds, our hearts, our lev. And as we were hearing the old Kedushim say, then you will start seeing the transformation on the outside of one. So as Yahweh, he deals with the inward parts. He deals with our lev. He deals with those things that we are without by showing us, as Dawid said, we must have truth.
Yeah.
There's no other way, Yisrael. We must have truth in the inward parts. Why? Because even in those secret places that are not revealed, Yahweh says, I will put in those places, those realms. He said, I will fill it with wisdom. I will fill them with hukmah. If you desire wisdom, you desire truth in the inward parts. Now, what he goes on to say in verse 7, he said, in order that I may ascertain unto this Almighty Yahweh, he says, to purge me. Why did that we express that? Because he understood those things that were within. He understood that he must have truth within the inner parts. Despite all that he has done, he knew this. So he says unto Almighty Yahweh to purge me with hyssop. This a cleanser. It's somewhat it's bitter. The Torah of the Mitzvah may seem bitter for the moment, but if we will receive it and swallow it, Yisrael, that it will bring sweetness in the inward parts. It will bring health and wealth to the bellies, Yisrael. Our navels will be fat, not with sin, not with iniquity, but with truth. In the inward parts. Truth in the inward parts. He says, purge me with hyssop. And he said, and I shall, without a doubt, I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than even the pure snow. You know something about snow, the purity of when it falls? The sun hit it, it almost blinds you. It's just so pure that it reflects the light. It actually reflects the light. We should reflect Yahshua HaMashiach. We should reflect truth. We should reflect light within the inward parts, because those things within us, Yisrael, it will be seen.
Yes, sir.
Was there not judgment in Yisrael, Yeshurun? Was it seen? It was revealed by the sword, was it not? So as it is with light, as it is with truth. That's why Dawid prayed this way, because he knew within the inward parts. If I receive your mitzvah and your truth, your Torah, that I will be clean, I will be washed, even whiter than snow. He says, make me, Almighty Yahweh, that I might hear, that I may hear to hear joy and gladness.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. Make us, make me, Yah, that I may hear the truth, the joy, the gladness, this tough message of Yahshua HaMashiach. And what was that message? That we be people that repent. Why? Because the time is at hand. That we purify, that we cleanse ourselves, and make ourselves ready for the coming of the bridegroom. He says, make me to hear joy and gladness. He said, that even my bones, that which sustains and holds me upright, which you have broken, that they even may rejoice. Did he break him? Sure he did. But he said, even knowing that it is you that have broken my bones, we should not let the world break us. Yahweh is not going to allow that. If there are any bones that should be broken in Israel, it's going to be by Almighty Yahweh. And even at that, we should barak Yahweh. Even at that, we should give Torah unto Yahweh. Even at that, we should understand, just as Dawid said, you have broken me, you have brought me low, Almighty Yahweh. He said, but I told you that my bones have been broken. Why? Because they rejoice in your judgment. They rejoice in your truth. And he prays to hide your face from my sins, from my sins. I have transgressed the Torah. I have walked contrary to your will. I have sinned. I have sinned before your Almighty Yahweh. And he says, blot out my iniquities. Hallelujah. And there's only one way that our sins and our iniquities shall be blotted out, Yisrael. It has to start here. It has to start here in the lev, the lever, the heart, the mind. By the Torah, by the mitzvah, by the truth continually being spoken, Yisrael, and the dam apply, that we may be cleansed. And then he asked this of Almighty Yahweh in verse 10. Why? Because he knew what was within. He knew those things that he needed within. He knew that truth had to abide within, and that it took the purging of those things, those things that needed to be taken away, that he may be filled with truth. This is what he says in verse 10. He says, create. Did not in the Bereshit, in the beginning, did not Yahweh create? He said, create in me a clean lev. We have to have a clean lev, Yisrael. We're not going to walk in the mitzvah unless we have a clean lev from within. The inward parts, they have to be clean, Yisrael. He said, create in me a clean lev, Almighty Yahweh. And he says, and renew.
Renew.
We have to be renewed, Yisrael. We have to be renewed, transformed, replace those parts to the point where I run with efficiency according to your mishpat and your Torah. And when you rebuild an engine, I'm somewhat of a shade tree mechanic, if we use that term. But you can take the same block, and many times the engine will be a stronger engine, more horsepower, and more efficient. Why? Because sometimes you have to go in there with the walls that the pistons travel in. That's where you get your horsepower from. Sometimes they have to be cut away and made smooth again. And if you do that, then the old parts, they don't fit. So you have to get new parts that it can be fitted into that engine. So you take that same engine and you put in those things which are necessary, then the product of that is even better many times than before. So we want Yahweh to renew us. With a tzaddik, a righteous ruach. Hallelujah. So we must discard all those old things, our own ways, this old way of thinking. As we heard, the path that does not lead unto righteousness. We must forsake all those things, that the renewing of the Torah, the mishpat of Almighty Yahweh, may fill us, Israel. We must be filled. We must desire truth, as that we prayed in the inward parts. Verse 11, he says, to cast me not away from your presence, O Yahweh, and take not your Kodesh Ruach from me. But he says in verse 12, as I continue to heal him, but he says, restore. Restore us. Restore us, Yah. Restore me, Abba. Just as I talked about that engine, it was just a restoration. It was restored. It's the same engine, the same block, but it has been restored. That we says, restore me, Almighty Yahweh. Restore unto me the joy of your Yashak. And uphold me with your free HaKodesh Ruach. He's uphold me. Uphold me with your Ruach. Uphold me with that anointing, Almighty Yahweh, that I may stand. That may continue to walk in those ways that are pleasing in your sight. Is that not what we should desire? Yisrael, Yah. That's what I desire. That's what Yahweh does even. Yahweh even desired this, the righteousness in the inward parts, Yisrael, Yah. But you cannot fill a vessel that is tainted. The vessel has to be clean. It has to be washed. And it has to be purged, Yisrael, Yah.
Oh, yes.
In 1 Samuel, if you would turn with me to 1 Samuel, still talking about the things that are within. So we know we must have truth. There has to be righteousness. There has to be truth. The mishpat of Almighty Yahweh must abide in the inward parts. Hallelujah. Let's see what it says here in 1 Samuel chapter 25, verse 32.
Hallelujah.
For we should desire the righteous judgment of Almighty Yahweh, should we not? Even the judgment many times is so, what's the word I can use? It's so vast that the comprehension of that, it does not awaken us.
Yes.
We look through a cloud. We look at the judgment of Yahweh cloudedly. It's not really a heart that fully understands what the half of Yahweh really can do, Yisrael. So it says here in 1 Samuel chapter 25, verse 32, and Dawid said unto Abigail, blessed be Yahweh, the sovereign master of Israel, which has sent you to me this day. Why? Because he was ready to tear this kingdom or this establishment down. Why? Because he asked that his men, that his people, his accompaniment would be somewhat comforted. Some food, some water, and it was denied of him. So yet, the judgment, which was a righteous judgment, was kindled within him. But there's a point that I want to get to concerning Nabal. He was a fool, was he not?
Yes.
Reading on. He said, you have come to me this day, and blessed is your discernment. And he said, blessed be to you, which has kept me this day from coming to shed blood and from avenging myself with my own hands. Was he not righteous in his judgment? Of course he was. Verse 34. For in every deed, as Yahweh, the servant master of Israel, lives, which has kept me back from hurting you, except you have hastened and come to meet me. Surely there had not been left to Nabal by morning light any that pisseth against the wall. They said there would not have been anything left. You know, we look at a word, as it says here, pissing. We think, oh, that's a bad word. You shouldn't say that. You should say pee or urinate. No, it's the same as what we say, the defecation of the dung. It starts with the S before the tenderness of ears. You know, we're something. We hear that continuously as people, as a nation. Yeah. We have been taught these things that we shouldn't say these things. It says pissing. Yeah. There would not be anything left, not even a dog, if I would have come through. Verse 35. So David, he received of her hand the gift which she had brought unto him, and said unto her, go up in Shalom, in your house. He says, see, I have hearkened unto your voice. He said, I've hearkened unto your voice. You have brought these gifts. You have somewhat apologized. I understand the state of this man. He said, return unto your house in Shalom. He said, I have accepted your person. We should desire Yahweh to accept our person. If we allow Yahshua HaMashiach to be within us, is he not within us? The Yahweh, he accepts the person of Yahshua HaMashiach. Why? Because we have been renewed in his mind, in that mindset, Israel. Verse 36. And Abigail, she came unto Nabal, and behold, he had held a feast in his house, like the feast of a king, drinking, gorging themselves, but drinking to drunkenness, folly, playing. They'd have no idea. They didn't even realize that Dawid and his mighty army was outside of the city. He did not even know. Because if he had knew, he would allow them passage. He would have done what was right, but he was drunken. That's why we cannot allow the cares of this life to drunken us. Yeah. We cannot allow the thoughts of our minds. Well, I believe I'm doing right. It's not believing you're doing right. It's knowing that one is walking according to the statutes and the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. See, Abigail knew the protocol and what was needed. Why? Because she has some righteousness within the inward parts. That she was able to present her man, herself before the messenger, before the man of Almighty Yah. And it says, the feast was like the feast of a king, drinking, dancing, falling on the floor, all that foolishness. And Nabal's heart, it was merry within him. Without any kind of care, it was merry. No thought of destruction or impending judgment. For he was very drunk. If we are drunk with the cares of this life, we will not even realize the things that are taking place. I'm not so much speaking about the things in the world. I'll talk about the things in our own life. I'll talk about the inward part. Those things that are within. And I will deal with without, those things are without, but I want us to understand the things that are within. He did not understand because he allowed his mind, his love, his heart. It was merry. It was drunk with the things of the life, this life, that he did not or was not aware of the judgment that awaits. He was not aware of the sword that was without. He says here, it was merry within him, for he was very drunk. Wherefore she told him nothing, less or more, until morning light. So she let it go, because he was not even cognizant. He would not even understood what she was saying unto him. Verse 37. Listen to this. But it came to pass in the morning. She waited until the morning, to the light of day. Give him time to somewhat having a hangover, give him time to somewhat get his faculties together, that he had some kind of judgment. The morning came to pass. Then the wine, it was gone out of Nabal. And his wife had told him of these matters. that his heart, that his left, that his mind, it died within him. It died within him. See, we don't allow this mind or the precept of our own carnal mind to die within us. Why? Because we're so drunk. We don't know that even the sword of Almighty Yahweh is without. And we have allowed so much within that we are drunk with the cares of this life. And we do not even know the judgment of Yahweh is ready just to take us at any moment. It said that his heart died within him, Israel. Don't think you cannot die from within. You can die from within. His heart died. His heart died because he allowed so much of the drunkenness within. That he's not even aware of the sword that was without. And the Torah says that he became as stone. He died. He became stiff. He could not respond. He was unresponsive. You find yourself unresponsive to the truth, Israel. It just shows that there's a death there. There's no enlightenment there. But yet the judgments of Yahweh, his sword is still without the gate, Israel. The sword without and terror within. Did he not feel that terror that it even took his heart? Why? Because he knew that Dawi was not playing. He knew that this man of Yah was standing for righteousness. And he became stiff as stone. That's why we must hearken, Israel, y'all. We must have our ears that we hear, that we listen to what thus saith Almighty Yahweh. Verse 28. And it came to pass about 10 days after that Yahweh smote Nabal. So he didn't die just right then. He was just, as we were here today, he was just a vegetable. That mind, that heart had died. Yeah, he was someone in a coma state that he could not even assess his faculties, his body. He could not even make his wrongs right. So the Torah says that 10 days after that he died, he was taken, he died. Do we not think that the judgment of Almighty Yahweh, if we discount what we hear of the sword that is without Israel, that Yahweh will not judge us? And if we do not take heed unto the warning, we don't think he will take our life? He will kill us. Yes, he will. He will destroy us. Even our children, he will, Yisrael. So we must take heed. And how do we do that? By understanding those things we are without. So we must allow the Torah. You're not going to understand those things. You're not going to understand your love without Torah. The Torah, it must come in. It must make a change. The Torah must come in and renew. That's why Dawid prayed what he prayed. Because he knew that the Torah had to come in. And it had to renew those things, Israel, in his life. Make them new again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Again, Tehillim chapter 40, verse 1. We must have confidence, Israel, in the mitzvot, the Torah of Yah.
I will.
We're still talking about those things that are within. We must have within us, Israel. So we must have the right love. We must have the right mindset within us that we not fail, that we not die before our time, that we not taken by the after anger of Almighty Yahweh, but that he is pleased in everything that we do, what we say, Israel. He says in Tehillim chapter 40, verse 1, I'm going to read 40 through, verse 1 through, what do I have here? Hallelujah. A few verses here. Verse 10, it says, I waited patiently for Yahweh. That's one thing that as a nation, as a people, and I could speak of my own self, is having this patience. We want everything instant to the point where we don't wait on Yahweh. Yahweh has many things in store for us, and they're beautiful, wonderful things, but we must have patience to wait. He said, I waited patiently for Yahweh. And he inclined unto me, and he heard my cry. He brought me up also out of a horrible pit. He said, out of the miry clay. It was filthy. It would cause one to drag. It's hard to get up. It's miry. He said, he had brought me out of the miry clay, and he has set my feet upon a rock, and he has established my goings. Has he not set us upon the rock of Yahshua HaMashiach? His Torah, the mitzvah of Yahweh, is a rock for us to stand on. It's not Yahshua the living Torah. So if we stand on him, then we shall abide. We shall not be moved, Yisrael. He said, also you shall establish even my goings, the path that leadeth unto the Melkut. You shall establish my feet that I not slip. Verse 3. And he has put a renewed song within my lamb. That's one thing about a song. You can always renew a song. You can always add words to a melody and change the melody. It has to do, as we hear so many times, it's more of what is within a man, in one, that causes the Tehillims to flow forth. That's what true Tehillim is. He said, he has placed a renewed song in my mouth, even praises unto Yahweh, my Abba. He said, many shall see it. Many shall observe it and hear and shall trust in Almighty Yahweh. He says, blessed is the garment valiant warrior that makes Yahweh his trust and respects not the proud, nor such as turn aside unto lies. So we should not respect those that are proud, those that withstand the mishvuf, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. People don't want to hear that. And if we'll be honest with ourselves, many times we don't want to hear that, Israel. So we should hate that inward man. We should hate that thought process, Israel. He says, I have no respect or no trust to those that are proud and that turn aside unto lies. He said, many, O Yahweh, my Almighty, are your wonderful works which you have done. And your thoughts are to us. He said, they cannot be reckoned up in order unto you. He said, there's so many that I cannot reckon them, place them in order as they happen. Your thoughts, the tough deeds you have done unto me, Almighty Yahweh. He said, if I could declare and speak them, there are more than can be numbered. He says in verse 6 that sacrifices and great offerings you do not desire.
Yes,
yes, yes. He said, that's not what you want. Sure, we bring an offering as a zabah before Almighty Yahweh. But it's the obedience he desires, Israel. It's the obedience he desires. It's more than what you do, but it's the obedience behind what you do. And what you do is very important. And even the works of that are very important. But as we heard, it's the lamb that you do, and that's what Yahweh desires. So he says that the sacrifices and these grain offerings you do not desire. He said, my ears have you opened. He said, burnt offering and sin offering have you not required. Are our ears open, Israel? Do we yada? Do we understand what he is saying? He said, lo, in verse 7, then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me. He says, I delight to do your will. How is one able to delight? One is able to delight because of the riches and of the treasure that one has within. One is able to delight in Torah, even at the small things. If we would deem them to be small, that Yahweh does, we find the light. He said, I delight to do your will, O Yahweh, my Almighty. And yes, your Torah is within.
Yes, beautiful.
He said, your Torah is within. It's within my lab. It's within my heart. It's in my thought process and the things that I do. He said, it's within my lab. And he expresses this. He said, I have preached righteousness in the great congregation. Lo, I have refrained my lips, O Yahweh. He said, you know, there's things I have refrained my lips from. Verse 10. He said, I have not hid your righteousness in my left. He said, I have not hid your righteousness within my leaven. What he was saying, I have not held it within. I have not ceased from speaking those things that are true. I have not ceased from the within the congregation of Yisra'iyah expressing what you desire of a house. He said, but I have declared your faithfulness, and I have declared your Yasha and your Teshua. He said, I have not concealed your steadfast loving kindness and your truth from your great congregation. He said, I'm not withheld those things. Those things that are wonderful, you have enlightened me with truth. I've studied the Mishpat of Torah, and you have brought this great truth unto me. He said, I've not withheld it from the house. Why? Why was he able to do all this? Why was he able to speak unto the house of Yisra'iyah? Just as he said in verse 10, he said, why? Because I have not hid the righteousness within my heart. He said, I've not withheld anything from the house. I have spoken what you have given me to speak. So he spoke from those things that are within. Yeah. Do we have that mishpah? As the Torah said, it seems like it was the fire that is shut up in the bones, Yisra'iyah, that by some means it had to come forth. He said, I have not withheld it. He said, I have expressed your mishpah in your Torah. Why? Because of the righteousness that are within my inward parts. Tehillim 36, verse 1. A few scriptures here. Still talking about within. Have not even got to without just yet, Yisra'iyah. I'm going to have to revisit this, hallelujah, concerning without and within. Yes, that's right. Psalms 36, verse 1. He says, the transgression of the wicked says within his left. Why? Because it's a land full of corruption and deceit. It's a land full of lies. It's a land that abhors, he hates mishpah. He hates any kind of truth. He said the transgression of the wicked says within his land, his heart, that there is no fear, there is no dread of Yahweh before his eyes. He says that within his heart. I do not fear Yah. I don't fear the sword. I'm not afraid of what Yah could do unto me. That's a fool. That's what he says within his heart. For he flatters himself with his own eyes until his iniquity be found to be hateful. Does not even see his own ways. He flatters himself. Verse 3. For the words of his mouth, they are iniquity and deceit. This is one that says within his heart, I do not fear Yahweh. There's no misfood. There's no fear of Yahweh. No wisdom within my mind, within my heart. He has left off to be prudent, to be wise, understanding, watchful. A fool leaves off all those things. For to do right and kindly. Can't even do right. Those things that are siddiq. He cannot even be kind. He cannot be kind to others, not even those in his own house. That's why we should be kind, Yisra'iyah. We should have a hava. We should do those things that are right, even to those that are outside Yisra'iyah, but especially those of the household of Emunah. Come on, Yisra'iyah. We must do those things that are right, because what that shows, if we don't do those things, that wickedness is within the heart. Deceit is within the heart. Lies and transgression lies within the heart, Yisra'iyah. We're just going to have to be honest with me. Hallelujah. He said he devises iniquity upon his bed. He doesn't fear Yahweh. He said he devises iniquity upon his bed. And he sets himself in a way that is not tough, that is not right. It is not tough. And he abhors not evil. He doesn't hate evil. He doesn't find a path or a way around evil. He goes to evil. He creates evil. He does evil in the eyes, in the sight of Almighty Yahweh. Tehillim chapter 39, verse 1. Talking about those things that are within. So we cannot say within our lives, Yisra'iyah, that we discount the dom, that we discount the word, we discount the mishvuth of Almighty Yahweh and his judgments. Verse 39, verse 1. He says, I said, I will take heed to my ways, that I sin not with my tongue. That's the only way we are going to be able to not sin with our tongue. We must take heed to our own ways. We must search, ask Yahweh to search those things that are within Israel. David prayed that.
Yes, yes.
He says, search my inward part. See, find, see if there will be anything wicked, any wicked way that is within me. He said, that I sin not with my tongue. He said, I will keep my mouth with a bridle while wickedness is before me. He said in verse 2, that I was dumb with silence. And I held my shalom, I held my silence, even from Tov. He said, and my sorrows, they were stirred. You know, we could be amongst the company or group of the wicked, and we can blend right in, and that does not trouble you, and what they do does not trouble you. And there's something wrong, Israel, y'all. See, even here, even though he was amongst those, he did not intermingle with them and got all, if I use the word, fuzzy and comfortable with them. Yet his love, it spoke with great words, but yet he held his shalom. He was not comfortable in the midst of them. He says, my heart, it was hot within me. Your love should be hot. It should be heated with the righteous eye of the anger of Almighty Yahweh. Why? Because he is angry with the wicked every day, is he not? But yet we're not angered with our own ways. We're comfortable with ourselves and with what we do. We can discount on a whole and an akim, we think that's all right. But it's not all right, Yisrael. He said, my heart, because I've seen the wickedness around me, it was hot within me. Our love should be hot, Yisrael. It should be alive with the mystery of the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. We should allow the cold that comes from Hashemayim to land upon our lips. That we speak those things that are right, that we speak those things that are siddiq, Yisrael. He said, while I was musing, so while I was somewhat, as that word expressed, being patient, just for the moment, and in my life I was complaining. There was complaint in me. I didn't like what was going on around me. That's what that word expresses and moves. It's complaining within one, murmuring. He said, the fire, it burned. He said, then spoke I with my tongue. See, we don't want to reprove those wicked things. We don't want to speak because of those things that are within Yisrael. We don't want to speak because of the surroundings. We want to feel comfortable and blend in amongst the wicked. It should not be Yisrael. He said, my love was hot within me while I was complaining in my love, in my mind. The fire burned. Then I spoke with my tongue. He says, Yahweh, make me to know my end. You see where his mind was at? Even though amongst the foolishness and the frivolity, yet his mind, he was hot. It was on Torah. The mitzvah was going through his mind. And he had to speak. He said, Yahweh, make me to know my end.
Yes.
And the measures of my days, that is, that I may, Yada, may know how frail I am. May know how frail I am, how weak I am. We must know how frail and weak we are, Yisrael, that even the strength of Almighty Yahweh, his mitzvah, his Torah, makes us perfect. It is our strength. It is what makes us perfect. It gives us the ability to move on, Yisrael. He says, behold, you have made my days as a handbreadth. That's not very long. A handbreadth. He said, my age is as nothing before you. He says, surely every Adam man at his best state is altogether vanity.
That's all I
have. He says, altogether vanity. Shalom. So we'll allow the inward parts to be filled with the mitzvah and the Torah. And it's not that we don't hear it constantly. We hear it constantly, Israel. We're without excuse. Just as David prayed, he said, allow my ears to be open. Yahweh has allowed our ears to be open that we may hear. Those of you that are listening by via of live stream, you're hearing. This is not a difficult thing to understand. It is easy. So Yahweh have opened our ears today that we may hear, that we may understand, that we eradicate those things that are not pleasing to Yahweh that is within us, and that we allow the things that should be within the inward parts. I'm talking about those things that are within to fill us, to enlighten us, and to encourage us, Yisrael. Again, as I continue. Tehillim chapter 55. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Before I read that, let me read this one scripture in John. Turn to Tehillim 55, verse 1. But Yahkahana expressed this in 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. He says, "You are Almighty Yahweh, there is no other." So you are Almighty Yahweh. "And you are of Almighty Yahweh, little children." He's speaking to the house of Israel. "And have overcome them." We have overcome the world, the enemy. We have overcome by the dam, the blood of Yahshua HaMashiach. "Because greater is he that is in you." Greater is he that is within us.
Yes, that's
all right. Yahshua that is within us. The testimony of the established mishru of the word of Almighty Yahweh.
Yes.
"Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world."
I like that.
We're greater, Yisrael.
Yeah.
So let us not intermingle thinking that we are their equal. We're not their equal. We're the head. "And by this we are able to do all things in Yahshua HaMashiach." Tehillim chapter 55, verse 1. He says, "Give ear unto my prayer, Almighty Yahweh, and hide not yourself from my supplications, from my cries, from the pleading of my lev, my heart." You know, sometimes there are times where the sorrow of one cannot be expressed by words. It's only by the moaning and the tears. It's only by the supplication those things can be expressed, Yisrael. So he says, "Attend unto me and answer me." He says, "I mourn in my complaint."
Yes, I know that.
"And I make a noise." He didn't say, "I make a word."
Yes.
He didn't say, "I quote Torah, a scripture."
Yes.
"To mine." He said, "I make a noise."
Mm-hmm.
He said, "I groan, I make a noise."
Yes.
"Because of the voice of the enemy, because of the oppression of the wicked. For they have cast iniquity upon me, and in wrath they do hate me."
Yeah.
You know, we place ourselves in certain situations where we're just encountered by that every day.
Yeah.
Those of you that are listening. But greater is he, greater is the Torah, the Mishnah that is within you,
yeah,
than those that surround you, Yisrael.
Yeah.
Don't let the world allow the world to beat you down by the wickedness and the frivolity. There's always a tap or a source of strength anytime you go to the website or the phone number here at Teshua Community. We will give you strength. We will tell you what you need to do and what you must do, Yisrael. Don't allow the world to run you over. Many times we find ourselves within the business areas and things of that nature. Don't allow your left to be taken. Ak.
Yes.
Yes. Ahok in. Because greater is the word, the mishvut that's within you than those that are in the world. They have nothing.
Yes.
They have nothing. You're there because Yahweh has placed that in you for you to endure and to overcome and to show strength. He said, "Because of this oppression, this the wickedness of the iniquity of those that hate me," he said, "my heart is sore pained within me." I know sometimes it hurts. If that we expresses this in the Torah, the Mishnah, then there's not any one of us that have escaped or have not found ourselves in that kind of position. But yet, it's the mishvuf, it's the Torah, it's by emunah that we have our way out through Yahshua in all things, Israel. In all things. You don't have to walk around because of what the world does and the oppression of the world. Hallelujah. But he says this, that my lev, it is sore pain within me, my mind. And the terrors of death, they are fallen upon me. He said, fearfulness and trembling, they are come upon me. And horror has overwhelmed me, my mind. But listen to what he said, what he spoke. He says himself here in verse 6. He said, "I said, Oh, that I had wings like a dove. I had some kind of escape. We always have an escape in Yahshua HaMashiach. That's our only escape. That's the only way we're going to find comfort. That he's the only place we're going to find any kind of relief. He said, for then would I fly away and be at rest. He said in verse 7, lo, then would I have wandered off and remain in the wilderness, Shelah. But let us remain in Yahshua. Let us remain in the Torah. We can always escape unto the midst of the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. All that we need is in him. Joy we find, contentment. Life would be worthless without Yahshua HaMashiach. Todiyah. Tehillim, 94 verse 15. As I begin to bring this to a close, and I will return back into this Yisrael. And before I close, I will express a few verses here concerning without. But turn me to Tehillim a few verses, chapter 94, verse 15. You know, we must find benefit in the judgments of Almighty Yahweh. Why? Because we benefit. It enlightens us, it strengthens us, it fortifies us. You know, when you're dealing with steel, and if you have dealt with steel, if you want to harden that steel or fortify it, it takes heat. It takes the intense trial of heat. And then you immediately cool it down, and it makes it harder. It makes it as flint. It makes it somewhat stronger that it does not bend. It is stiff. So we must allow the judgments of Almighty Yahweh to make us strong, Israel. Tehillim 94, verse 15. But judgment shall return to righteousness. Yes. And all the upright and left, they shall follow it. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers? Who will rise up?
Yes. Yes.
Who will make a stand? Does not Yahshua stand for us, Israel? Yes. He says, or who shall stand up before me against the workers of iniquity? He said, unless Yahweh have been my help. Yahweh here is our help, Yisrael. He's our ever-present help in the time of need, in the time of trouble. He said, unless Yahweh have been my help. He said, my nephesh would have almost dwelt in silence. I told Yahweh for his help, for his special help. It comes right from him, Yisrael.
Hallelujah.
Verse 18. He said, I said that my foot slips. That your steadfast loving kind, O Yahweh, it held me up. Many times, every time, that's the only thing that holds us up when we slip. You know, it's a relieving thing when you slip, you're able to grab hold of someone or something. Because you can hurt yourself. This body is frail. The body is frail. You can bump it, you can bang it. You might not feel it then, but it will show up. But he said, even as I slipped, and I began to fall, yet Yahweh, he held me up. And in a multitude of my thoughts within me, Torah says, because of the multitude of the thoughts, aren't there not a multitude of thoughts? You know, Yoshim and I was talking because, you know, what we do, we have to be real careful. And then sometimes you may trip or something may happen, and you'd be surprised how fast things go through the thought process of your mind. You remember this, you thought about this, you remember that. As I've heard some say, it seemed like flashbacks. When you're placed in a certain situation, it doesn't take long, the mind calculates, it goes through all that, and you almost see it before you end up on the ground. But he said, because Yahweh hears my help, and in the multitude of my thoughts within me, he said, it is you, Almighty Yahweh. It is your comfort that delights my nephesh. So he has the thoughts have to be within us, Yisrael. The mitzvah has to be within us. We have to be lightened from within, Yisrael, that even the very thoughts of our mind may be the delight of our nephesh. Hallelujah. Should not our thoughts be thoughts of tough things. Pure things to the pure. All things are pure. So as Yahweh works in our life and allows certain things to transpire, it's all for our learning, Israel. He says, I find comfort. Even in all of my thoughts, I find comfort. Because my nephesh, it delights. Hallelujah. Just a few scriptures here that I bring this to a close today. In this expression of without. I've talked about somewhat just of a small microcosm of what Torah expressed of within. So let us deal just a few scriptures here for without. Beginning again in Tehillim, in Bereshith. I start off with Bereshith chapter 6. I want to start here in chapter 1, verse 1. And we somewhat know this by repetition, by love, by heart. But in the beginning, Yahweh, he created the Shemayim, the heavens, and the Olam, the earth. So he has made all things. Nothing was by some accidental boom or bang. Yahweh created all things. So you can throw that in the trash. Verse 2. And he says, he created the Olam, did he not? When he created it, it was without form. That is Tohu. That is without form. There's confusion, there's darkness, there's emptiness. That's what is in a mind that is not formed. It is not filled with the misfood, the misfood of Almighty Yahweh. It is without form, it's void, it's empty. So it has to be filled. Did he not speak? And then things began to happen upon the Olam. Then we see the beauty of it, even today, if you will look, the beauty of it. But at the beginning, it was without form and empty. Empty. And the Torah says, and darkness was upon the face. Is this not an expression of the writs or the earth, these earthly vessels, these earthly tabernacles? Yeah. Without the Ruach or the life, the light of Yahshua HaMashiach abiding. This is speaking about us. Without form, there's emptiness. We look in the aspects, we look and we stare, and there's emptiness there. There's nothing there, no life. There's darkness. Even upon our faces, just as it is upon the face of the deep. And the Ruach, HaKodesh of Almighty Yahweh, moved over the surface of the waters. And Yahweh said, let there be light. And there was light. And Yahweh, he saw that the light was excellent. His Torah, his mitzvah, his revelation, as he reveals the dark places, that it was tough. And there was light. Verse 4. And Yahweh saw that the light, that it was excellent. And Yahweh, he made a division. He divided the light from the darkness. So from the Bereshit, from the beginning of all things, did not Yahweh make a difference from darkness to light, Yisrael? Yeah. Then why do we tend to straddle the fence?
Yes, I do. Yes.
It's those things that we are without that causes us to lack. It's those things that we are without that causes our minds to be empty. And that is not being filled with the mitzvah, the Torah, the judgments of Almighty Yahweh. Happiness, enlightenment, contentment, emunah. It's because we lack the light, Yisrael. We have to have the light in Yahshua HaMashiach. And he has been revealed unto us, Yisrael.
Yes.
So he made a division between the night, the darkness, and the light. Verse 5. And Yahweh, he called the night, the light, day. And the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning was the first day. So Yahweh, he makes a division. Why? Because if we are without the mishpuf, the light, there will be darkness. Upon your face and your left and your heart, Israel, we will be without. You know, I can recall hearing the song that without Yahshua, I can do nothing. Without him, I would fail. And we would fail without him. Without him, I am like a ship without a sail. We're just out in the middle of nowhere, Yisrael, without the mitzvah of Almighty Yahweh. Talking about without. Let me read this here quickly. And I'm going to close here in Romans chapter 1, verse 21. Let me begin reading here. And I will close here in Romans. And I will continue this Yisrael in a later time. Hallelujah. It says, because that when they knew Yahweh, they magnified and honored him not as Almighty Yahweh. So there was a knowledge, there was an understanding of Almighty Yahweh, was there not? But just as we heard earlier, we did not esteem the rock of our Yasha, of our salvation. The Torah says, neither were they thankful, but they became vain in their imaginations. And their foolish love became darkness. Does not it say that? It became darkened. Did we not just talk about the foolish love, what the foolish one says in his, within himself? There is no judgment. There is no Almighty One. There is no Yahweh. For their foolish heart was dark, professing themselves to be wise. They became fools. And changing the splendor of that which is incorruptible in Almighty Yahweh into an image made like unto corruptible man. Is it not what we have done, Yisrael? Yes, we have corrupted because of our own deeds and our own actions and what we desire and what we do, our lies and our deceits. Yes, we have purported an image that is not of Almighty Yahweh. He said, a corruptible man, and unto birds, four-footed beasts, and creeping things. Therefore Yahweh also gave them up unto uncleanliness through the lust of their own hearts. He just gave them up. To whatever they wanted and desired to do in their own, in the darkness of their own hearts, he gave them up to do those things. It says, even to dishonor their own bodies between themselves. Yes. Who has changed the truth of Yahweh into a lie and worship and serve the creature more than that which had created them. Who is blessed forevermore. Bless you, Abba. Todaya. This is so, and let it be fulfilled. It says in verse 26 in Romans, he said, for this cause Yahweh have gave them up to vile ordinate affections. For even their women did change the natural use unto that which was against nature, even against those things that Yahweh has established by his mitzvah, his Torah, what he designed a woman and a man for. He said it went against that. Yeah. And likewise, also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, they burn in their lust one towards another, men with men working that which is unseemly, and receiving themselves that recompense of their error which was met. You see what darkness does, Yisrael? When one is full of darkness within, they discount the mitzvah, the Torah of Almighty Yahweh. Even the order of things that by mere observation seems righteous and tzaddik, they omit all of that. Verse 28. And likewise, verse 28. And then as they did not retain Almighty Yahweh in their knowledge, Yahweh gave them over to a reprobate mind. A mind that is dark, a mind without the consciousness of Torah, of mitzvah. So even a natural man, and when I say that, there are things that a cognate man would not do. If his understanding has not been enlightened, one, his mind has not been seared or darkened, that he would just do because it's just righteous to do those things. There are people that would do righteous just because it's righteous, and not because they have been enlightened. I've been washed in the dam, if you understand what I'm trying to convey, Yisrael. They would just do righteously. But this mindset, even at that, would not do it. Those things that are siddiq, those things that are right. It says in verse 28, and even as they did not retain Yahweh in the knowledge, he gave them over to a reprobate mind, to do those things which are not convenient and not proper. being filled with unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, malice, full of envy, murder, contention, deceit, malignity, whisperers, backbiters, haters of Yahweh, despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things. You know, we invent evil things. We invent things and situations in our mind that's not even so. And it's so evil for us to do that. We think about our king, we think about our, we think of a messenger. Because of what we invent, we lay in our beds and we correspond back and forth. And Torah has not been applied, Yisrael, y'all, it is wrong. It said they're inventor of evil things, disobedient even unto their parents. Is there not a promise unto a child when they obey their parents that comes from Almighty Yahweh? That he would even increase their days upon the Olam that Yahweh gives? That's what Torah says. But even here it says that they were disobedient even unto parents. So even the youth did not walk in those things that were convenient. Verse 31, they said, without understanding, covenant breakers, and the Torah says, without natural affection, just the lawful affection. Ema loving the babe, the child of her womb. Even at that, it's just a thing that Yahweh ordained to be so. And yet they even left off from being there. How can a mother forsake her son or her daughter, her child of her own womb? They said they were without natural affection, implacable, without chesed, who knowing the judgment of Almighty Yahweh, did you hear that?
Yes.
Knowing willingly, who knowing the judgment of Almighty Yahweh, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but they have pleasure in them that do them. So let us not be without mitzvah, without Torah. We must be filled, Yisrael, with truth constantly. We must hear it constantly, Yisrael, that we not lack, that we not be without. Because without the mitzvah of Torah, we're just like, oh, this is us. This is the people. This is the world. This is a nation without truth. Or the mind that has been seared from Almighty Yahweh and that abides in darkness. So let us not be without truth, without dark, without his light, without Yahshua HaMashiach, because he has revealed his tough pleasure. He has revealed his will unto us, Yisrael. But we must walk in them. So even though his judgment, the sword, is without the gate, Yisrael, yet there should be shalom within the house of Yisrael. Not dismay, not terror. Why? Because we understand, and we yada, we know what Yahweh is doing, because we walk in his truth, his mitzvah. So let us not be without Yisrael. We need his judgment. We cannot be a people without judgment. We cannot be without Zakane'im, elders. We cannot be without instructors. We must have those in the congregation. We must have those in the house. Any business, any organization, they must have them. They have to be there because there's those that set the rhythm, they set the order, and they set the way, Yisrael. So we cannot be without truth, and we cannot be without the leading of the HaKodesh Ruah. So we greet you all on this beautiful Shabbaton. We have joined with us here in Beit Kovet Yisrael here at Teshuva, that we may hear the simplicity of his truth, that we may be enlightened, encouraged, Yisrael, to continue in this way, not to forsake this way, because it's only by this way of truth that we shall enter into the gates of the Melchut, the kingdom.
Yes,
hallelujah. So let us walk in that mindset now today, Yisrael. We must. We can't wait unto them that all of a sudden, okay, I'm ready, my mind is right to enter into the Melchut. We must be in this mitzvah now, because this is his order. This is the order of HaShemayim. This is the way he has established us to walk and to live, Yisrael, with and amongst each other. So let us ahava one another greatly, Yisrael, and by that we show our ahava towards Almighty Yahweh, by obeying that commandment. Hallelujah. Let's at this time stand to our feet. For Yahweh hears tough, and as we have heard, that he implores us constantly to repent. He gives repentance unto us, Israel, Yah, that we may understand his fear. You know, he's the only one that can give repentance, Israel, Yah. No one else. So as we have heard, we should fear it. And I have Almighty Yahweh greatly. Hallelujah. Almighty Yahweh, do barak you for this another day. You have given us, Abba Yahweh, this yom, this time, Abba Yahweh. You've given us life. You've given us breath that we could come, that we can hear, Abba Yahweh, your mitzvah being poured out from Hashemayim. We do ask, Abba Yahweh, this day that you would strengthen Israel, Yah, those that are listening. In their bosom, Abba Yahweh, you would fill them with the water of life, Abba Yahweh. And what will your Ruach HaKodesh, Abba Yahweh? Those that are sick in their bodies, that are weak, that are hurting in pains, Abba Yahweh. Allow your mitzvah, Abba Yahweh, to comfort them this day, Abba Yahweh. Because in your mitzvah, in your Torah, in Yahshua, we do find all that we need. Comfort, strength, life, all those things, Abba Yahweh. For we told that you will barak you for all things. Those that have traveled, you will return them safely, Abba Yahweh. That your Torah and your Melekim will be around. Kol Yisrael, Yah, in all things we give you told in the precious name of Yahshua, HaMashiach, we do declare. Hallelujah. 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 Shabbat shalom, Kol Yisrael, Yah. Shabbat shalom.